to you all. So today we are going to see the continuation of the prose lesson, The Portrait of a Lady, written by Khushwant Singh. So in our previous class, we saw the relationship between the author and his grandmother, that is the grandson and his grandmother. So every day she used to wake him up and she used to get him ready for the school, and also she used to pack the things required for him the day, and she will walk him to the school every day. So after that, when his parents, they moved on to the city and settled over there, both of them, the grandmother and the grandson, they also moved to the city, and from there, the relationship between the grandson and the grandmother took a turn. So from there, we stopped over there, and today we are going to see the rest of the story. So now we'll move on to the text. As the years rolled by, we saw less of each other. For some time, she continued to wake me up and get me ready for school. When I came back, she would ask me what the teacher had taught me. I would tell her English words and little things of Western science and learning, the law of gravity, Archimedes' principle, the world being round, etc. This made her unhappy. She could not help me with my lessons. She did not believe in the things they taught at the English school and was distressed that there was no teaching about God and the scriptures. One day I announced that we were being given music lessons. She was very disturbed. To her, music had lived association. It was the monopoly of harlots and beggars and not meant for gentlefolk. She said nothing, but her silence meant disapproval. She rarely talked to me after that. Here, years rolled by means time passed, and distress means suffer from extremely sorrow, anxiety or pain, and lead to association means indecent or obscene. And harlots means prostitutes, and gentlefolk means people of noble birth. So in this paragraph, the author says that as the time passed by in the city, the interaction between the grandmother and the author got reduced. So for some time, she continued to wake him up and she would get him ready for school, and she would ask him what he had learnt in the school that day, and the scientific terminology and the English words that made her very unhappy, and she was not able to understand all those things. So she could not help him with the lessons, as his new school never taught him about God and religious scriptures or something. This also made her very sad. So she did not approve of such kind of education, and also when she came to know that he was getting into music lessons, and that also disturbed her. He was feeling upset because according to her, music was very indecent, and it was an art for the beggars and prostitutes, and that was not belonging to the decent families. That was according to the grandmother. So she didn't like that he was learning music, so she stopped talking to him. When I went up to the university, I was given a room of my own. The common link of friendship was snapped. My grandmother accepted her seclusion with resignation. She rarely left her spinning wheel to talk to anyone. From sunrise to sunset, she sat by her wheel spinning and reciting prayers. Only in the afternoon, she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows. While she sat in the veranda, breaking the bread into little bits, hundreds of little birds collected round her, creating a veritable bedlam of chirpings. Some came and perched her legs, others on her shoulders. Some even sat on her head. She smiled but never shooed them away. It used to be the happiest half hour of the day for her. Here, snapped means break suddenly and completely. Seclusion means the state of being private and away from the people. Accepted a seclusion with resignation means here the grandmother, she accepted a lonely life, and as she accepted the separation from her grandson without objection. So here grandson means the other Khushwant Singh. Spinning wheel means a household machine with a wheel attached to it for spinning yarn. A veritable bedlam of chirpings means here it refers to the noise and confusion caused by the chirpings of the sparrows. And veritable means used to describe something which is very interesting or unusual. And bedlam means confusion. Chirpings means the noise of a small bird. And perched means alight or rest on something. Shoot means make a person or animal go away by shouting or saying shoo. So So here, as the author, he went to university to study. He had a room of his own. The parents, they gave him a separate room. So the common link of his friendship with his grandmother and that they had when they shared the same room was changed, and now their friendship with her was ended. So she became more private and she spent her whole day spinning the wheel. So from sunrise to sunset, she would sit and silently recite her prayers. And in the afternoon, she used to feed sparrows in the veranda. She'll break the bread into small pieces and she'd feed hundreds and hundreds of birds over there. So the birds would gather around her, and some will sat near her, some will sat on her legs, some birds will sat on her shoulders and few on her head. So she never shooed them away, and she was feeling happy. So she always smiling on seeing the birds. So that was the happiest hour in her whole day. When I decided to go abroad for further studies, I was sure my grandmother would be upset. I would be away for 5 years, and at her age, one could never tell. But my grandmother could. She was not even sentimental. She came to leave me at the railway station, but did not talk or show any emotion. Her lips moved in prayer. Her mind was lost in prayer. Her fingers was busy telling the beads of her rosary. Silently, she kissed my forehead. When I left, I cherished the moist imprint as perhaps the last sign of physical contact between us. But that was not. After 5 years, I came back home and was met by her at the station. She did not look a day older. She still had no time for words, and while she clasped me in her arms, I could hear her reciting her prayers. Even on the first day of my arrival, her happiest moments were with her sparrows, whom she fed longer and frivolous rebukes. So here, sentimental means a feeling of sadness or tenderness, and emotional feeling. And beads means a small pieces of glass or stone threaded with others to make a rosary or necklace. And cherished means hold something very dearly. And moist means wet. Imprint means impression or stamp. Clasped means hold tightly. Frivolous means not having any serious purpose or light-hearted. And rebuke means disapproval of something or someone. And frivolous rebukes means light-hearted scoldings. So here, when the author decided to go abroad for further studies, he believed that it would be the last time he would see her, as he would be gone for 5 long years. So as they all reached the station, she held him so tightly and she kissed his forehead. And he thought that it was the last physical contact with her. So the wet impression when he touched him of her hand was very dear to him. And when he saw her, she was not sentimental at all. And when he came back after 5 years, she came to meet him at the station. She looked just the way she did 5 years ago, not a day older. And she held him again in his arms and was still reciting her prayers. So he noticed on the first day of his arrival that only sparrows would make her very happy. In the evening, a change came over her. She did not pray. She collected the women of the neighborhood, got an old drum and started to sing. For several hours, she thumped the sagging skins of the dilapidated drum and sang of the homecoming of warriors. They had to persuade her to stop to avoid overstraining. That was the first time since I had known her that she did not. The next morning, she was taken ill. It was a mild fever, and the doctor told us that it would go. But my grandmother thought differently. She told us that her end was near. She said that since only a few hours before the close of the last chapter of her life, she had omitted to pray. She was not going to waste any more time talking to her. Here, thumped means hit, and sagging means sinking downwards, and dilapidated means in a state of despair or ruin something. And the sagging skins of the dilapidated drum means the loose surface of the worn out drum. And persuade means to talk someone into doing something, or it's more like requesting. And overstraining means overdoing something, and omitted means leave out or exclude something. So here, an evening, the grandmother, she didn't follow her regular routine of praying. So she collected a few women from the neighborhood and she got a drum and started singing with them. So she thumped means hitting. She hit the ruined part of the drum and she sang along with the women of the neighborhood. So the whole family, they were persuading her to stop, as maybe she might get ill due to the exhausted feeling. So the next morning she fell ill as they predicted, and it was a mild fever. So the doctors, they called upon the doctors, and the doctors, they told them that it would go away, but the grandmother, she took it very differently. So according to her, she said that she would die soon as her end was near. So she started chanting prayers, and she started reciting all the things, because she didn't want to waste her last hours in talking to anyone. We protested, but she ignored our protest. She lay peacefully in the bed, praying and telling her beads. Even before we could suspect, her lips stopped moving and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. A peaceful pallor spread on her face, and we knew that she was dead. Here, protested means express an objection against something or someone, and pallor means an unhealthy, pale appearance. So here the family, they started objecting her, and they tried to stop her, but she lay peacefully on her bed chanting prayers and doing her beads. And suddenly she stopped, and her lips stopped moving, and the rosary fell from her lifeless fingers, which means she was dead. So a calm, pale appearance, it's spread over her face, and she was dead. We lifted her off the bed, and as is customary, laid her on the ground and covered her with a red shroud. After a few hours of mourning, we left her alone to make arrangements for her funeral. In the evening, we went to her room with a crude stretcher to take her to be cremated. The sun was setting and had lit her room and veranda with a blaze of golden light. We stopped halfway in the courtyard. All over the veranda and in her room, right up to where she lay dead and stiff wrapped in the red shroud, thousands of sparrows sat scattered on the floor. There was no chirping. We felt sorry for the birds, and my mother fetched some bread for them. She broke it into little crumbs the way my grandmother used to and threw it to them. The sparrows took no notice of the bread. When we carried my grandmother's corpse off, they flew away quietly. Next morning, the sweepers swept the breadcrumbs into the... Here customary means traditional, and crude means in a natural state roughly made, and cremated means dispose of or burn a body after it is dead, and blaze means a very large burning fire, and shroud means a piece of cloth used to wrap a dead person, and corpse means a dead body. So here the family, they lifted the dead body of the grandmother from the bed and laid her on the ground, and they wrapped her with a red colored cloth, and thousands of sparrows, they sat silently near her. So the author's mother, she felt so sad on seeing all the sparrows, so she fetched some bread for the birds, but they didn't eat any. So they flew away later as the family carried the dead body, and the sweeper, she removed all the crumbs the next morning. So the birds were so sensitive, and they did not want to eat bread, but they were mourning the death of the one who had fed them for so many days. So this is how the story ends. So here the story puts light on the need of companionship and also the friendship felt by our elders, our grandfathers or our grandmothers, and also it shows how love and emotion is experienced not only by human beings but animals and birds too. So here the sparrows also shows the love and friendship towards the grandmother when she was dead. So this is the end of the story. I hope you all understood, and please keep on reading the text again and again for better understanding. Thank you so much for watching.